to wake up all these sleeping people. Oh, Simund Gautierre. You have a mansion in the middle of the mountains, don't you?
Hmm?
Gautierre Mansion? Sure you've heard of it. Do you know of any nobles that hired mercenaries recently?
Yes. There was Strong Minds operation.
Strong Mind?
That's about all I can remember, though.
Strong Mind?
Goodbye.
That's all I got to ask him, huh? Strong Minds operation. Guide to Sturk. That updated my map. How to befriend a goblin. Penned by the renowned scholar of goblins, Entus Altus. Sweet. I'm really looking forward to reading these. Yay!
Hello.
You saw nothing. They're coming for me, aren't they? Tattoo? Cool. Wolf Queen books. Darkest Darkness. Wait, I had the wrong key. Huh. Very noisy. Oops. What about these books? The Big Bad Bear? The Big Bad Bear and the Very Good Forester. Awesome. The Wind from Oblivion. Doesn't sound familiar. The Goblin with the Golden Arm. Wow. I am very happy right now. In defense of the Ruby Navy. Wait. This is introduction. Is that a different thing? In defense of the Ruby Navy. Isn't defense with S-E at the end? So this is introduction to the Ruby Navy. The Magic of Dust. Dusk, sorry. Traveler's Guide to Bruma. Nice. Okay. See, this is what we get to do when we don't have a dog following us around. Bookcases. These are all Skyrim books. Not completely sure about the Bear of Morkoth. Although, it says I've read it. But I don't really rely on it, because it says I have read Pala Volume 2, or I haven't read it. It also says that I haven't read The Wolf Queen, and I know that I have. I've read all those. Great Harbingers? Doesn't sound familiar. And that might be the dog trying to get to us. Stay away! City of Stone is another one about Morkoth, I think. The third door, not sure. This also doesn't have the eye thing next to it. You know what I'd love to see? More Herbane's Bestiary. Did I look at this one as well? Yeah. Well, even if I didn't, I have all those. Okay. Oh. Nibbin Herald, Lost Scribonia, novel published. Oh, it's not a novel. It's a letter. 150 years after she wrote her last novel, Casta Scribonia is still making new generations of Imperial readers squirm with ever-worsening discoveries. A set of notes and rough drafts in a moldy box in a coral attic recently prompted one of the biggest upsets in literary history, and this week the hysteria reached terrifying new heights. Casta Scribonia's lost novel, The Magic of Dusk, was published today in full, sans even the most cursory attempts at putting it into a presentable form. I just found that book. Full of missing passages, hackneyed cliches, and puerile dialogue, Dusk appears to be little more than a discarded fantasy of Scribonia's, an idle self-insertion into an infantile romance with a vampire lord of all things. Green Emperor Publishing, not content with publishing the ghastly original notes, have taken a disastrous decision to fill in the details themselves, making this latest edition little more than a pale copy of a hack writer's personal fantasy. This, however, did not stop hordes of fans storming every bookshop and printer in the Imperial City, all clamoring for a copy. First edition, a local institution, ran out of all editions of the book within minutes. This craze has not gone unnoticed, and Dusk has created a disproportionately large impact upon Cyrodiil's public. Passionate debates over throwaway lines common amongst the younger generations, book burnings amongst the pious, and even a full-scale production set to take the Nirn Theater have been talking points over the last few days. The author attempted to read the book, but found he'd rather a good quill-weave thriller instead. Well, this author attempted to read the book. Okay, so you didn't even read the book. Festus Otis, arts critic. The Nibbin Herald, because a good story is more important. Well, I guess I'll take it, why not? Interesting. Mysterious Akavir. Had that one. I've been through here. And I just come from here or no? We could sneak now. That's right. I can do this. Nibbin Herald, save the Nirn Theater. And now look at that. The threatened closure of the Nirin Theater, an outrageous affront to the sensibilities of the cultured, is simply the latest blow in a string of intellectual and artistic attacks from a ferociously pro-Kalovian regime that the current establishment has openly withdrawn funding from such a historic centerpiece is nothing short of a willful purge of Nibonese influences in our once great capital city. Gone are the shining performances of the Actors Guild, its members disappearing into the arms of far-flung patrons. No longer will we hear the cheers and cries of the crowds held in rapture as masters of their craft dance and sing before them. This decision to end the existence of one of the last shining jewels of Imperial Majesty will sound the death knell of color and joy in our once great city. Sound your fury, citizens of the Imperial City, and let the Medes know that this time they have gone too far. Would you rather see your children brought up on the blood and gore of the arena, or the heroic tales of Topal the pilot? Help save the Nirin Theater today. Donate a few gold pieces. Festus Attis, Arts Critic. The Nibon Herald, because a good story is more important. So these are... this is like a newspaper, but more in the form of, like, letters. Because it's sealed and everything. Usually nothing useful in tables. Before I look at that, let me see if there's any good books. Race swimming. I think... I think I've read this, but just in case. Sovngarde, a re-examination. Definitely gonna be checking out. Seeing if I read this stuff. Artist Guide to Painting, Volume 1. Cool. Cheeses of Tamriel? Cool. Affirmation of Titus Mead the First. Iliad reference text. I picked up that bear, right? I know, because some of the things I looked at... yes, okay. The Asylum Ball? Oh, these are all new. I had no idea they added so many books. This is amazing. There's that book, Magic of Dusk. I'm pretty sure we picked that one up. So guys, just bear with me. Oh, I have two of them. What'd I do? Drop two of them? Wait. Where'd they go? I guess I put it into the bookcase? I don't even know. Well, let me grab one then, since apparently I got rid of both of them. Not sure about this. Yingol and the Sea Ghasts? Ceremony made. Alright, his journal. This journal contains numerous irrelevant entries, including many referring to the unwanted affections of one Afana Udici. Ah, poor girl. Other mundane accounts, including shopping lists, grievances with the guard Captain Adius Vilius, and the death of Leith Arcus, the beloved house cat the beloved house cat he brought here from his Nibonese home. One entry, however, even when skim reading, sticks out like a sore thumb. It's Frostfall, and some orc mercenaries have come through the city looking for work. One of them's a brute of a man, the other a rather charming orcish dame. Even if only because of her good looks, I've given them a job. Curious to see how things will go. Jazar's. Jazar has always been one for surprises. I think I just leave this here? Or do I take it? I took it. Oh, am I was supposed to plant this? In where? Ugly love. I have a lot of things to do. Collect payment. Where am I supposed to plant this letter? In the end table? Is it note or letter? Wait. Letter. Oh wait, I didn't mean to do that. Well, I didn't get anything completed, so I'm thinking. A fana, right? Take that too. Maybe I'm supposed to put it in there. I left it. Too bad unwanted affections, anyway. Empty. Yet he puts the point curses next to it. Although I guess that one's an illusionary one. Okay. Yeah, I'm a sneaky one. Hi. How you doing?
Oh, hello. Is there something I can help with, madam?
How do you like serving the Count of Bruma?
It's a fair position, at least on a temporary basis. The pay's decent, and we get food and free rooms. So I can't complain.
That's good.
My brothers up in Skyrim would probably laugh seeing me here.
Think so?
They can take giant's clubs to the face for all I care. I like the people here.
Is that a
especially panna? Old Farzvar.
Hmm.
Try not to trip and smash anything, yeah? If you do, you're cleaning it up yourself.
I am, huh? Is that you, Afana?
Hmm? Did you do it? Did you plant the note in Gautierre's drawer? I am a flutter with excitement.
Yes, I have.
Excellent. Here, take a bit of extra coin. My treat. I can't wait until Simund reads it.
Not sure if he's that into you.
Can I help you?
Nope.
See you around.
You know what's even more satisfying than arresting a criminal? Seeing them rot in a cell.
Whatever you're into. Having a chat?
What is it?
You're having a chat. Satisfied? Yeah, nightingales. Fact.
Good morning.
Good morning. That's the Great Hall. This is the Service Hall. I'll check out the Service Hall. This is a big castle. A big city. Someone stole your sweet roll. Brief history of the Empire. See ya. All this beer and mead.
Excuse me, I'm busy being the Count's good little chef, so if you don't mind.
What's the matter?
Good morning.
What do you do here, besides be the Count's good little chef?
What do I do? What does it look like I do? Sit in a rigid chair all day? I'm a servant of the Count. The castle's chef, to be precise. I cook the food around here, and I do actual work, unlike some petty nobles around here.
Pretty hepped up, aren't you? You don't like serving the Count of Bruma?
That obvious? Yes, I know it's supposed to be a great honor, and my future children should worship me for putting up with it. But this isn't how I planned to live my life. Back in the good old days, I owned my own bakery in the Imperial City. Citizens from all over Tamriel came to sample my cuisine. Unfortunately, some deals I made to keep my business going went south. Far too fast for me to adapt. I lost everything. Well, suffice it to say, now I'm here. Reduced to serving. Ugh.
Ugh. Can I buy food from you?
Buy some? What do you think, this is a storefront?
Yeah.
Oh, who am I kidding? I could use the gold. Here, let's see if we can make a trade.
I don't really need any of this stuff. But I feel bad, he says I could use the gold. I'll take an orange from you.
See you around.
Good day. Picking the bread.
Can I help you?
Got out. Oh, as far as Var. History of Biography of Byron Zaya, real volume 2. I think that's the good one, right? The juicy one. Oh, I don't want to pickpocket him. Oh, good. Why am I gonna talk to him sneaking?
Can I help you?
Oh, I talked to you, sorry.
Farewell.
Farewell. Guest wing. The Great Hall. The Lord's Manor. feast fit for lords. Hi. Oh, the dog's back. Dog's back. Oh, noble bed. Everyone's following me. Stuck in the door. Oh my. It didn't work. Damn it. I don't want a magic dog. Prayers to the eight divines. Well, I can't take this because what if she can see me through the door? I don't know if I'm being seen by the dog or someone else, so screw it. I'd probably be fine, but I've been apprehended once already. Treasure room door, huh? Oh, she's watching me. I found the sultry Argonian bard. That goes to the guest wing. Great hall. Poison song books. Bruma court notice. Can I read this without taking it? Oops, sorry guys. As of today, Count Decilis Carvine. Oh, that's why I called him Count Decilis, and then he said Count Carvine. So it's his first and last name. Excuse me, as of today, Count Decilis Carvine will be accepting visitors from 9 in the morning to 6 in the afternoon. Please ensure that whatever matters you bring to the Count are of great import, as his time is most valuable and should not be wasted with trivial issues. By decree of the always loyal Rignar. See, I didn't take it. I just looked at it. Alright. Great Hall. Yeah, back out to the Great Hall. It was really carefully watched there. I did not miss the dog. I'll tell you that much. Oh my. The Count himself is there. Okay. Came from over there. This goes out. Their library, which I'm not even going to look at. Oh, I want that Saints book. Nightfall? I want these books. Ekaviri Diary Translation. Oh, shut up. Saving the Count for last, as I'm sure you can tell. That goes to the service hall, and then
hmm?
Vike, I talked to you, right?
How can I help you? What is it?
Yeah, I talked to him.
Talk to you later.
Vignar.
Hmm?
I have talked to him, and he was asleep.
Bye.
Bye.
Can I read this? Black Horse Courier? Imperial War Galley sunk. A makeshift fleet of rescue boats descended upon the shores of Sturk recently, as every ocean-going vessel from the humblest fishing junks to the most imposing Imperial warships scrambled to the wreck of the Warhaft, an Imperial frigate, to search for survivors. The Warhaft had been floundering in heavy weather following a perilous journey back from a patrol in the Iliac Bay, and was due to stop at the port city of Anvil. It suffered irreparable damage from a collision with a reef near Sturk before much of the crew were rescued by a passing merchant vessel, the Tidewalker. 6 sailors remain missing, while 11 hands have been confirmed lost. Sailors of the Tidewalker have confided in this reporter that the survivors claim to have been attacked by a band of Red Guard pirates, while a ship of similar description to the vessel has been seen traveling near Anvil. The offices of the local count described these claims as fanciful, noting that it was unlikely a band of pirates could ever dare attack an armed legion ship, let alone then travel to an Imperial port. Survivors of the wreck were unavailable for comment. Antus Germain, Colovian correspondent from the Black Horse Courier. The Black Horse Courier is Cyrodiil's premier newspaper, providing objective commentary on current events in Cyrodiil and beyond. You need to look no further than the Black Horse Courier for all your news needs. Hello, Count Corvine.
Good afternoon.